genius. This is where normally Richie would test out your recipes, your little snack geniuses, and work out whether they are snack genius or snack hell. We've got some which we're going to do, but first of all, let's deal with the thing, and I do mean a thing you've brought in this morning. So, what is this called?
This is... it doesn't have a name.
Let's call it DT's Love Sausage.
Let's call it that. An excellent title.
Could you explain it?
This comes from... I must have been about 12, and one night my mum got really annoyed with us all and went, oh, make your own tea.
Yeah.
So I went, right, okay, I will. And went ferreting in the fridge. I found soft, spongy, cheap and nasty pan loaf bread.
Yep.
Some cheap sunflower spread.
Yeah.
You know, the Mattison's U-shaped smoked pork sausage.
Yeah, this is something I've never heard of before.
Really?
The U-shaped pork sausage.
Yeah. That's it. Comes in a little sort of shrink-wrapped thing.
You guys ever seen... I've never seen
that. Never seen that before,
I mean,
David,
I know obviously in Scotland that passes one of your five a day or something.
Yeah, absolutely.
Revolting-looking thing.
It's a tube of processed meat.
Lovely.
It's probably... I mean, there's hardly any saturated fat in this at all.
No.
So you smear the bread with spread, and then on top of that, you smear it nice and thick with some crunchy peanut butter.
Yep.
And then you cut the sausage into discs and sink the discs into the peanut butter.
I love that there's proper detail in this.
Yeah.
This is what Snack Genius is about.
Squish it all down.
Yeah.
And you've got a particularly excellent sandwich.
Now, you had some during the news. When was the last time you actually had that?
It's been quite a few years since I have sampled this, but it took me right back. It still tastes as good today as it did then.
Richie, you are the king of Snack Genius.
Don't wrinkle your face at that, Richie, or was that an involuntary twitch?
It's a twitch again.
As everyone knows who listens to Snack Genius...
Normally you take huge bites out of all the food.
This is going to be a timid bite.
Oh, come on.
Here we go.
He's cut them into triangles as well, which is the right way to cut sandwiches.
Thank you.
What?
I love peanut butter. I hate peanut butter.
Overcome the peanut butter.
Well, I feel like...
That's not a fair trial.
I feel like the judge is slightly against me there. Come on, Christian, you have
Rich,
a go.
Rich, can I try a bit of this mess?
Oh, he really doesn't like peanut butter, does he? He's looking for a spittoon now. Oh, man!
Oh, that's disgusting. Seriously, that is absolutely disgusting. You just spat it out like a child.
Ew.
You are 34.
Come on, Christian.
There's a weird smell from it.
Just...
do you want a piece of paper?
Don't tell me that's nice.
Come on, that's lovely.
That is not... The
that's
word is
absolutely
not lovely.
Absolutely delicious.
That texture of the cold meat in your mouth is not...
nice.
That is actually one of the worst ones we've had
for
a while.
Oh, come on. Give it here, I'll finish it.
No, honestly.
Where is it? Yeah. Oh, you're all wrong.
The good thing about that is white bread and peanut butter. The unwelcome bedfellow in there, the Ryan Giggs of it, if you will, is your pork sausage, sir.
Don't compare my pork sausage with Ryan Giggs.
That is foul. That is not Snack Genius.
It's horrible. Snack hell.
No, honestly, that is wrong.
I'm disgusted.
No. Rich, what else have we got to try this morning then?
Okay, a hooligan. Sounds like a Doctor Who enemy, but it's not. It's a sandwich of your preference. So we've gone with ham and cheese. And what you do is...
I have
you...
a sandwich here you can put it
no,
with.
Thanks.
No, we're not
we've moved on from that.
And... I'm David and I play the Doctor. There's something hugely exciting and thrilling about being part of a line that stretches back through time.
There's a special handshake.
Yeah.
We can't share it.
No. Again,
you just want to, you know, you want to mine him for all his knowledge and that voice.
Yeah.
Oh, it's like, yeah, it's like chocolate and treacle and sex.
Yeah.
All together.
Yeah.
Well, this has all the makings of your lucky day.
He does love people. And that's a great gift. In this day and age, to love people makes the world a better place. And I think David, in all that he does, makes the world a better place. But then, as you must realise, I'm his dad.
Oh, man! Ladies and gentlemen, this year's Special Recognition Award goes to Mr. David Tennant.
I am so... glad I didn't get stuck in traffic. This is very an out-of-body experience. So much of tonight now makes sense. All those people lying to me. Oh my goodness, here we go, it's then. Gold, look.
We started. So David Tennant, you weren't expecting to be back again.
I'm shaking. That's quite a thing to have sprung on you.
Congratulations, special recognition.
That's amazing.
So they wondered whether you'd guess it when Pixie Lott started singing, then it was the Proclaimers.
No, I was saying to Georgia.
Your
favourite, I was saying that, oh, she's singing a Proclaimers song, that's amazing. And then Craig and Charlie appeared, and then everything just became a blur, frankly, after that.
Was your heart going when you were watching that V2?
Oh, I mean, it's unbelievable, because it just didn't, you know, it doesn't compute with something like that. You're sitting in a room and suddenly everyone's kind of looking at you. That's weird. It's a very weird experience.
I mean, it was almost like, so it was loads of your life's work flashing before you.
Yeah.
Was there anything that you've forgotten and you're like, oh, I forgot that?
I'd have to go back and look again. To be honest, the whole thing just becomes such a kind of sensory overload. It's all just a bit much.
Anybody? Have you got any memorabilia from any of the shows that you've done? Do you take anything away?
I couldn't possibly be drawn on that. I'd probably perjure myself.
Did you nick something out of the TARDIS at some point?
I may have been given some things to take home with me. Yeah.
So where are you going to put your special recognition award?
Oh, I don't know. I've no idea. It's lovely gold colour, isn't it?
You can show off to the others in the party because you've got a gold one.
Oh, I know. Am I the only one with the gold one? Yeah.
Special.
Oh, yeah. Flaunt that at the after party.
I will.
Take that with you.
Listen, very well deserved.
Thanks very much.
I hope you can go and take it in and enjoy it now.
I'll try my best. Okay. Thanks very much.
Congratulations. Have a good night.
Thank you.
What's one of the strangest encounters you've had?
Well, you know, followers of Doctor Who, as you say, they're enthusiastic, and that's lovely. It's lovely and an honour to be the focus of such enthusiasm. But it does, you know, it means you're asked for photographs and autographs kind of everywhere you go.
Mm-hmm.
And I was in the shower at the gym once. When somebody approached me, I mean,
in the
that's not,
shower?
You don't want to be asked, you don't want to be approached by a naked stranger at any time, but especially not when you're naked yourself and they're holding nothing but a piece of paper and a pen and they want to sign an autograph. And you think, I don't know what's the best way out of this. What do you want me to sign that with for a start? you know, the whole thing was very peculiar.
That's
but,
funny.
You know.
Did you sign it?
What else could I do?
I've heard some crazy stories, but that is a first for me. I've never heard anything.
No, but you've never been approached in the shower?
I've been approached in the bathroom, and it's the weirdest thing in the world.
It's,
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'm in the bathroom.
It's too close to human functionality.
It's way too close. I don't want you to know that much about me, nor do I wish to know.
Yeah.
Just keep a little healthy.
Decorum.
Yeah. You know,
decorum
it's just
and all
not the right place
you.
For that. I got to talk about this Facebook page, David Tennant in places he shouldn't be. You got to check this out. Look at this. These are pictures. What is this page about?
No, I was there. That's me. I definitely did that. You know, Kate was just very keen that I was giving her some
funny.
Support on the day.
And here are you hanging out with some kangaroos. David Tennant, wow,
yeah.
look at two of you on the
I
back of
that.
The
I don't remember doing that.
So, do you have a pet? Do you know what I do?
Do you really?
I never thought I would, but I have been... You get a family, you get forced into things.
Yes, you do.
Yeah.
Well, what have you got then?
Well, you know, I have a small dog named Myrtle.
I see.
Which is a little furry cockapoo thing.
Say it again slowly.
It's a...
It's not for me, it's for him. He just wants to check.
It's a... It's a furry cockapoo.
Thanks, David, for mentioning a real thing which you can't do anything about. So, how did you get a cockapoo then?
The family ganged up on me.
Oh, right, I see. Because you have the children, of course.
It's very sweet, but it wheezes. It gets so excited when it sees people that it jumps up. And, of course, it's quite cute, so people stroke it and it...
Bollocks!
Right away.
Are we still talking about the dog?
And so you're out walking it.
Right.
And people come up to stroke the dog. That's not... That's not a euphemism. They actually come up to stroke the dog.
Okay.
And they go, oh, the little dog! And they're going for it, and you try and get out... She
Crikey.
On your shoes! You try and get out as quickly as you can, but it's too late.
And then it's a lawsuit.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah! I was walking innocently, minding my own business, when my shoes were ruined by dog urine.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But people don't seem to mind.
No, they don't. People love furious. Dogs. People love animals. Animals get away with everything.
Yeah.